Lamborghini builds a Vision Gran Turismo car, Cletus McFarland's build battle is over, and Daily Driven Exotics sells the Supra. All of that and more in today's episode of Sinclair News. Welcome everybody back to another episode of Sinclair News. I am your host, AJ, Sinclair Photos, and I'm very, very grateful that you decided to spend a couple minutes with me today. We have a very, very interesting episode today, and we got a lot of stuff to cover. But before we do get into the news, I hope you guys remember we are still doing the $100 giveaway at 20,000 subscribers, and right now, we are less than 200 away from 19,000 subscribers, which puts us that's a little over 1,000 away from 20. Y'all, if you haven't hit the subscribe button already, please do it. It's free. You don't have to watch the videos if you don't want to. Just hit the subscribe button. It means a lot to me, and it makes that number on the screen look a lot cooler. But if you are interested in today's video, let's get right into it. Our first story today coming from Lamborghini. They unveiled what seems to be a Vision Gran Turismo car, very similar to the Bugatti Vision Gran Turismo car that we have over there in Southern California right now. Now this car looks absolutely insane. Looks like a spaceship mixed with a Formula One car, mixed with a video game, and they came out with this thing. It doesn't have a name other than the Vision GT for Lamborghini, and I really hope they make either this car a production car or implement some of the style details into the next car they put out, like the Aventador replacement that's coming next year, I believe. So I cannot wait to see that. Let me know what you guys think they're going to do with the Vision Gran Turismo car, and hopefully we get to see it out at a couple shows here in the future. Also, I think the biggest one will be Geneva, probably early next year. If you guys want me to go out to that, please leave a comment. That's quite a big trip, and I don't want to do it if you guys don't want to see it. And so if you guys want to see some crazy Geneva content, leave a comment down in the comment section below. That being said, on to our second story. And our second story today comes from Cletus McFarland. I haven't talked about him yet on the channel, even though I do watch his videos here and there from time to time. If you've been watching it the past week, you can see he's been doing the build battle with the two golf carts that they had two teams of people trying to build the fastest golf cart. And they had like a whole week-long process to do it. They just had to like maintain the body, like the regular chassis of the golf cart, and they could do whatever engine modifications to it they wanted, and they ended today. About 2 hours ago, he posted the video of like the final day event, and this thing is crazy. It's like a 100cc motor on a golf cart. They had a wheelie competition, like a burnout competition, and I think the farthest drag race or something like that, but his video is a lot of fun. The build battle is finally over, and if you want to see who wins, go hop over to his channel and check out today's video. But I'd highly recommend it. And our third story and our final story today comes from Daily Driven Exotics. I know, so mainstream, right? But he is selling his Toyota Supra back to the dealership that he bought it from. I really don't see why he would sell it back to the dealership that he bought it from, because what my guess is, they haggled the price down from the start, got a good deal on it because they're Daily Driven Exotics, modified the car, beat on the car for like 2 months now they've had it, cut up the car, wrapped it, turboed it, tuned it, everything. And then they're gonna sell it back to the dealership that they bought it from. And they're gonna definitely lose money, which I think they should have probably sold to CarMax, unless they're making the dealer give them a better deal than what they bought it for. But either way, I think it's gonna be harder for the dealership to sell it now, knowing that it's modified. You know what that car's been through and all the stuff that's happened to it. The only like good thing I could see coming from that dealership getting the car is that it's a Daily Driven Exotics exclusive car, and someone may be willing to pay the price that they want for the whole history of the Supra that they've had. So let me know if you think that's awesome that they're selling it, what do you think they're getting, or if you think it's kind of jacked up that they're selling it back to them kind of as a good luck trying to sell this kind of thing. Let me know what you guys have to think. I love y'all's opinions on everything in the comment section. I read them all. I respond to them all. So I love every single comment you guys post, good or bad. The bad ones help me make this show better for you guys. and make it to where you won't be upset if you see it the next time. So sadly, that's all for today's video. It was a short one, but we'll get more stuff coming in the future days. We did just get a new car here at my house, and hopefully that vlog will be able to come out tomorrow for you guys. Super excited to show you what it is. If you already seen it on Instagram, you know what it is, but YouTube will get it tomorrow. So y'all stay tuned for that, and always remember, watch the best and skip the rest. If you did like the video, please smash that like button, subscribe if you're new to the channel, and I'll see you in the next video.